And I was like, oh shoot, how am I gonna get rid of these pests? Like, what am I gonna do?
So I definitely need to water this. It's greened up a lot, so now we just have to wait for it to regrow. This is a worm bin. I really hate worms. Ta-da! Creation. Creation. Hello, my name is Benji, and today I'm gonna do a very chill, casual plant care maintenance day video where I just kind of walk around and take care of my plants, like watering or maybe repotting, or I don't know. I never really know what I'm gonna do. I just kind of walk around and see things that I need to do. Today is Monday, and normally I do most of my plant care stuff on Sunday, but I went to a friend's birthday party the other day, so I didn't get the chance to do this. Some of my favorite plant-related videos on YouTube are just people doing maintenance and taking care of their plants, like plant chores and stuff. And I like to watch or listen to those videos while I'm doing plant maintenance. So if you need to take care of your plants right now, then you can watch this video and we can take care of our plants together. I did a kind of similar video to this on my Patreon where I just gave updates. Like, I asked people what they wanted to see and I walked around and gave updates, and I thought it would be fun to do a similar style video on my YouTube channel. So yeah. Also, thank you so much to everyone who's joined my Patreon. It's been very fun. We have a Discord where we talk about plants and I give updates on there, and I have a monthly podcast that's really fun to record. The last one for January was about an hour long. If you want to hear me talk about random stuff, then check it out. Okay, but like I said, I don't really know what I need to do until I see it. So normally I would just like walk around and look at all my plants and see and think like, oh, what does this need? Does it need water or fertilizer or something? Normally I start in the living room area. So yeah, let's do that. Something that I've had to do recently is move the plants that are on the ground or like ground level up, because Theodore, or Theo, who's right there, he doesn't mess with the plants too bad, but he is interested in them, especially the soil on top. So I've moved a lot of the plants up just to be safe. That's why there's like random plants in weird spots for the most part. But I think I need to water a few of the plants out here. I did do some watering a couple days ago, so some of them don't need water. What I normally use to water is this watering can, or I'll bring them outside to my balcony, or I'll bring them to the sink. Okay, so this is my fiddle leaf fig, one of my first plants. Recently, I've been giving this a little bit more care because it's putting out more leaves. I think it's because it's sunnier now and it's warming up. So I do have to water this one fairly frequently. And there is a drainage tray on the bottom right here. So I'm not really like too worried about the water spilling out or anything. Ideally, I would take it outside and then like drench it completely, but it's a large plant and that's kind of difficult, so I don't do that. My Hoya linearis, look at this cute pot I repotted it in. It has, has a cat, and there's a cat on the other side that looks exactly the same, but yeah, very cute pot. I don't really have any like character pots, but this is the only one, and I thought it looked really cute. This plant is always like super thirsty, and I water it pretty frequently. And I recently got this anthurium. It's called an anthurium moodianum, and I got it from a trade. Recently, I've been doing a few more trades, which have been pretty fun. A new leaf is coming out. Very tiny, but it's cool. I'd like to take the time to thank the sponsor of this video, Aspiration. There's a good chance that your bank could be using your money to fund fossil fuel projects that destroy the climate, or use it for other things like political lobbying or private prisons. This is possible because your money doesn't just sit in a bank. Banks are allowed to use 100% of their customers' deposits as collateral for lending or investing. And they've contributed $3.8 trillion of this money to fossil fuels since 2016. Aspiration is a digital banking alternative that wants to change this. They are a B-certified corporation that will never invest your money in fossil fuel projects or other harmful industries. They are fully insured and regulated like a bank, making them as safe as any bank to keep your money in. They are a member of 1% for the Planet and donate 10% of their profits to charity. Something that I really like about Aspiration is that there are no overdraft, maintenance, or predatory fees. In college, I was victim to a lot of overdraft fees, so I really appreciate Aspiration for that. Their Aspiration Plus account offers 10% cash back on socially conscious spending and features carbon offsets for all gas purchases. Put your money where your values are and join Aspiration today. Special offer for Benji Plant viewers, go to joinaspiration.com/benjiplant or click the link at the top of the description and get $50 off when you sign up. Thank you to Aspiration for sponsoring this video, and let's get back to taking care of some plants.
What I really like about this house and this sink is that it has the setting where I can do this, and it makes it really nice for watering plants because it doesn't kick up the soil too much. So first I do an initial watering to allow the substrate to start accepting water, and then I do a complete soil drench. Because if I were to do like a complete soil drench like this without first giving it a little bit of moisture, the water like kind of spill out. So yeah, I like let it go down and then I do it again, and then I let it drain and then I do it again. I just leave it in the sink for a little bit to drain. Something that I've been doing recently is using like a kitchen rag and just putting it somewhere. I kind of do this to get some of the water out. Then I place it on this towel to drain out the rest of the water. And I do this because like if I'm watering multiple plants at a time, I need the sink space. So I use this towel as like a drainage mat, I suppose. I'm gonna water this plant too. It's my Monstera aurea. It looks different than the last time you guys saw it. I recently propagated it because it was putting out too much yellow. It has some growth points coming. Pretty cool. So this one, I'm also just going to water like this. And with these terracotta pots and the soil mixture I'm using, which is really airy, I don't worry too much about overwatering my plants, especially because now it's sunnier and it's a lot hotter. In LA right now, it is 80 degrees Fahrenheit, or maybe like 88 degrees Fahrenheit in these past few days, which is I think around like 27 to 30 degrees Celsius. Like I said before, initial watering and then I go in with more water. As you see now, it's like a little bit more accepting of the water and it is draining faster. For fertilizer, I've been using organic fertilizers. For the majority of my plant journey, I've used synthetic liquid fertilizers, but I really don't like having to mix the fertilizer with waterings and then really having to remember when I fertilize a certain plant. And I do like the idea of doing organic fertilizers because they're a pretty slow release and they have a lot of like micronutrients and stuff like that. I really like the idea of living soil or soil biology and like microorganisms within the soil. And right now I'm using alfalfa meal and worm castings. That brings me to this new thing that I'm trying. So this is a worm bin. I really hate worms. Like I really, really don't like them. Even the sight of them kind of like makes me shiver. Oh, it gives me chills. Yeah, I get chills thinking about worms. But I've decided to challenge myself kind of and invite them into my home because I really like the idea of composting and vermicomposting, which is composting with worms. I want to be able to make my own fertilizer and just be able to do something with my food waste and plant waste like dead leaves and cardboard and stuff. And so far it's been pretty cool. It's only been 3 days or so, but I can already tell that they're putting in a lot of work. The pile has kind of like shrunk a little bit. I'm really excited to be able to make my own fertilizer. I think that's really cool. Okay, and now, so I definitely need to water this. This is my philodendron heteraceum. It is very thirsty all the time because the pot is really small and has a lot of foliage, and it is right next to this window where it gets a lot of sun. Going back and forth to the sink is a big portion of the plant maintenance. So to get up there to water, I just use this stool and I stand on it and then I water. This plant is in a pot with drainage holes, but then it's potted in another pot without drainage holes. And because it dries out so fast, I don't really worry too much about overwatering. And it's kind of the same thing with my philodendron micans. It's in a terracotta pot. And as you can see, there's a lot of foliage. It needs water pretty constantly. Or else the old leaves start to yellow and die. Something that I feel like some people might not know is that when a plant doesn't have the water that it needs, it'll start yellowing mostly at the base. So the older leaves will yellow first
and then it will eventually reach the top if you don't water, especially with these philodendron varieties. So if you're noticing yellow leaves at the base of your plant only, that's probably either due to lack of light, not enough nutrients, or underwatering, which I think is probably the main culprit. I'm gonna bring this philodendron Jose Bueno and then this philodendron giganteum to the sink. Something that's nice about doing this top dressing is that it keeps the soil from overflowing and spilling out. Top dressing with lava rock or gravel or something really helps with that. This one is probably done draining now, so I'm gonna put it back in its spot. And now I will move this Monstera to the drying rack. These are my first two Hoyas, besides the Hoya linearis, and I got them at my first plant swap and they have grown a lot, which is really cool. I keep them in this west-facing window where they receive a lot of direct late afternoon sun. So this Hoya publicalix is very sun-stressed and it has these nice purple leaves. Watering these. This is my Anthurium vichii. It's grown a lot since my plant tour. Well, I guess it only grew one leaf, but look at this giant new leaf that I put out. It is much larger than the previous new leaf. Something that I think really helped was more light, but also because I kept the moss consistently moist. As the top got even a little bit dry, I watered it. And because it's in sphagnum moss and in this Vandapot where there's a ton of airflow, I don't worry too much at all about overwatering. Kind of same with this Regale. The reason why it looks all funky like this, I think, is because I did not water it enough. So yeah, I try to keep these as moist as possible, and normally I have to water like once every 4 days or so. If I have to water more frequently than every 4 days, then I try to repot the plant because watering more than that isn't very sustainable for me. I feel like a lot of people have questions about how I water plants that aren't in traditional or conventional pots. With the Vandapot, I just water it like you would with any other pot. I just like spray it with water and then I try and get the moss as wet as I can. Very simple. By the way, I water all of my houseplants in pots with regular tap water, but for my more sensitive plants like carnivorous plants, I'll use reverse osmosis water. Or for my cabinet, I'll also use reverse osmosis water. Now I will mist my cabinet. I try to do this once every day, but I can kind of go maybe like once every 4 days. That might be pushing it though. I hope you guys liked my cabinet tour, or my cabinet update. It's really grown a lot since I first set it up. Pump it up. I spray. This door likes to close on itself, so I have to keep it open with my foot. And that's probably good enough. So now I'm going to water my Song of India tree, also called Dracaena reflexa. I haven't really shown this to you guys much, but I've been growing other plants in the pot with the Dracaena, and I'm using the Dracaena as like a very large stake or as something to climb on. I kind of just water this plant whenever I feel like it, mostly once every week. On here, I have my Passiflora vine climbing up, and I don't know if you can see, but it's attached on with its little tendrils that it has. It's climbed up pretty far. It started with only one leaf, I think. And yeah, this plant grows really fast. It can handle direct sun and a bunch of other stuff. And then I have some Philodendron Splendid. And right here, this is a Monstera dubia. I'm hoping to be able to have it climb all the way up and maybe eventually have mature leaves. It's pretty cool. It's like a natural habitat for these plants because in nature, they climb on trees, and yeah, I have a tree. Over here, this is where I have a lot of my Platycerium, and I do get a lot of questions about how I water these. Wait, show them what Theo did. My dog Theo, this is the first time he's ever like really ruined a plant. So the shield frond is growing in really nicely, and then I left it on the ground for a little bit and he took a little chomp and broke it off. You can see his teeth marks here. It looks like a vampire bit it or something. I'll show you guys how I water these. I just watered these two recently. But I need to water this one. I water them normally once a week or whenever the sphagnum moss feels extremely dry. For smaller ones like this, I'm able to just water it in the sink. But for large ones like this, I have to bring it outside and spray it with my hose. So let's do that. I feel like people think that these are really heavy, but when they're dry, they are very light. I would say like less than 5 pounds. If you don't have a balcony with a hose or a backyard, you could probably water this in your shower. Just be careful about like stuff going down the drain. Okay, so I just put it here next to the drain and then I drench it. Oh wait, I closed the hose. And then I just drench it with water like this. That is pretty much it. And then I let it dry for a little bit and then I bring it back inside. Now that I'm out here, I actually realize I have some plants that I need to water. This is the passiflora vine that is growing in my cabinet and also on my dracaena. And look, it can grow in full sun out here in Los Angeles. So yeah, water, water, water. This is kind of how I do my plant care. I just see things that I need to take care of and then I take care of it. And then I just find something else eventually. What's nice about these balcony plants is that it's really easy to water because I just use this hose. And I water like that. Because it is so hot, I am finding that I need to water more frequently than I, oops. Water just spilled out of the pot. I find that I need to water more frequently than I was in the winter months, which, or I guess it is still winter, but it feels like summer in Los Angeles right now. Yeah, spritz, spritz here, spritz, spritz there, just spritzing. I've been wanting to get a little bit more into like gardening and growing vegetables or fruits or something. So these are peas. I don't actually even know if they're gonna grow well here, but these are sugar daddy snap peas, I think is what they're called. And yeah, so far growing pretty well. So it would be nice to have something that eat that I grow. My dad is really into gardening edible plants, so I have asked him a lot of questions and it would be really cool to be able to grow my own food. In this balcony bench pond, I have some fish. I have rice fish. And recently I noticed that I was getting some pests, like some aphids on this plant here, this Hydrocotyl verde salatica. And I was like, oh shoot, how am I gonna get rid of these pests? Like, what am I gonna do? Because I don't want to harm my fish in here and use a pesticide or something. But I was like, oh wait, these fish eat bugs. So now I've just been using the aphids as a natural food source for my fish. Kind of feels like I'm harvesting the aphids and I don't really mind them anymore because I can use them to feed my fish. Down here, I'm sure you can see a ton of these aphids. I kind of just like, pull a bunch of them off like that, and then I feed them to the fish. And I wonder if you'll be able to see them. Oh, there they are eating them. It's pretty cool. Also, something that's pretty cool about this is that a lot of dead leaves or flowers fall into the pond, like this leaf or this flower, and I just leave them in here because these snails eat them, which is really cool, and then they add nutrients back into the pond. So I haven't added any fertilizer into the pond, and I haven't really done many water changes or anything. And there's no smell coming from the pond, and I don't have any algae. So this bench pond is really cool. It reminds me of my cabinet because it feels like a little ecosystem. I'm just gonna quickly water the rest of the plants out here. Like I said, it's really easy. And this is another pond that I have. There aren't any fish in it, it's just plants. This little pond thing is doing pretty well. Lots of growth on this plant. And that's pretty much it for the balcony plants, but we'll probably come back out to water some of the larger plants inside. Okay, let's go. So now we're back in the kitchen and these plants have finished draining. So something that I kind of do is I move back and forth between different spots to allow the plants to drain. Now I'm just moving, oh, I'm sorry, Theo. He's so tiny. Now I'm just moving plants back to their original spots. Okay, so I think I've done everything on this side. I watered that and that. Oh, Theo. You having a nice sleep? We took Theo on a long run today, so he's pretty tired. And we did that because we were gonna film this video, so we wanted to make sure he wasn't like running around and acting crazy. And it worked. So I need to water these. I'm gonna go get my watering can and fill it up again. This Monstera needs water a lot because it's in a small terracotta pot and the soil mixture is really airy. It is a pretty large plant now and it gets full sun for the most part. This Philodendron Hedericium Lemon Lime also needs a lot of water. I just watered all of these Monstera recently, so they're fine. I do get questions about how I water this. And this one I do take out on the balcony because it is a bit difficult to water since I can't just set it down like a normal pot because it has this plant hanging from the bottom. Okay, so let's go to the balcony. I just water it like this, just how you would with like a normal pot. And then I have a hook here that I hang it from and allow it to drain. And now the Platycerium is probably ready to be moved in. Come on, Theo. 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 I'm gonna close the door on you. Come on. I'm gonna close the door. I'm closing the door. And then I just mount it back into its spot. Theo. Shh. So now I'm gonna go into the office room where I have my aquariums and I have some propagations that I don't know if you guys have seen yet. But first I wanted to show you how nice the lighting is right now. These are south facing windows, so we're getting a lot of direct light. Theo also enjoys it a lot. It makes this curtain area look really pretty at this time. And then I also really like how the kitchen looks. When the windows are open, the breeze comes through and it makes the curtains look really pretty when they flutter. Now we're gonna go into the office where I have my aquariums and some propagations. This is the aquarium I've been working on, and you guys saw it in a previous video. I've just been spraying it down to keep it moist like this because I'm doing the dry start method that I was talking about in one of my previous vlogs. Try to do this like every day, and hopefully I will not have to do it within about a month because it's been kind of annoying to have to mist this down all the time. In this aquarium, I ran out of CO2 for like 3 weeks, and a lot of the carpet died, and I did a big trim all the way down to the base, and it's doing a lot better now. Actually, it's greened up a lot, so now we just have to wait for it to regrow, which it will eventually. But I want to show you guys all these shrimp that I have. They've made a ton of babies. Look at all those shrimp. So many. And then right here we have some mini sphagnum moss terrariums that Chris and I are making. I used to make them a while ago, like, I don't know, the last time I sold them was probably like 4 months ago, and I have recently been starting to grow more live sphagnum moss to make these small terrariums, because I've seen that a lot of people ask for that since they're having difficulty growing their own live sphagnum moss. Here's one of these little trays that I have of sphagnum moss growing. I just use scissors and then I would like cut the top off pretty much like this, voila. And then I could just put it down here and then this part will grow and then the part that I cut off will also grow back. Sphagnum moss is pretty cool. It grows really easily and you can propagate it pretty easily. At least for me, I've never really had any troubles with this moss. Not trying to flex, just saying. I just watered this recently, but this is my Platycerium Ridleyi. and I think it's starting to form a shield frond. I recently remounted it to be more round because I watched this video where someone was talking about how this plant needs a very circular mount base. I want to show you guys this thing. I need to water this actually. But it's this interesting thing that I'm working on. It is called a tamandama, and it's like a kokedama, but it's like an arrangement of plants. I've been using the saran wrap to wrap the string of turtles around this and then have it grow into like a circle of string of turtles. And I think I can take it off now. I needed to keep it moist so that way the string of turtles would root into the ball. Ooh, look. Looks pretty cool. Does it look cool on camera?
Oh, that does look pretty good.
Nice.
Theo?
Oh my god, Theo. Stop. Normally Theo isn't allowed in this room because there's a lot of stuff for him to mess with, but he gets a pass this time. Oh, okay.
Dang.
Ta-da! Creation. Creation. Forgot about this. It is my Malabar spinach seeds that I'm trying to germinate in this paper towel. And I have one successful. So that's pretty cool. I really need to get this potted up. It's a summer spinach that can handle hot weather. So I'm actually gonna pot this up really quick. I keep my soil on my balcony in this trash bin. So I do most of my potting out there. This is the bin with my soil. It's really nice to have your soil in like one spot like this. I'm just gonna plant my seed and now I will just cover it with dirt. This isn't really a good seed starting mix. This is more of an aeroid mix, but I don't have any seed starting mix right now, but this should do just fine. So now I will water it. I really miss having a backyard like I did in Santa Cruz because it was way easier to water stuff and take care of things. So hopefully in my next place I live, I can have a backyard. Yeah. Okay, let's go back inside. These are just like a bunch of different propagations, a couple of Hoya in here and some things that I traded and some other propagations. I just don't really know where else to put these plants. So they are all designated here under the shelf with grow lights. Hello, Theo. I did recently just water these, so I'm not gonna water them again. But the way that I water these is I kind of just bring the tray out to the balcony and then I spray them all with the hose. And yeah, that's pretty much it. These trays come in handy definitely when you're dealing with a lot of small plants like propagations and stuff. Over here, this is something pretty cool that I haven't shown too much. This is a clay tube called a duotera base. I'm just gonna take it out so you guys can see better. It's pretty cool. There's a ton of moss growing and some aquarium plants and some orchids. And I also have some sundew up here. Because it's in this enclosed environment, I don't really need to water it very often, but sometimes I just spritz it with water to make sure that all the moss is wet. And right now I'm going to feed my fish in this aquarium. And I add a little bit more than normal because I want the shrimp to have some food too. So a lot of the food ends up going to the bottom of the tank for the shrimp to eat. I don't know if I mentioned this, but now I'm able to use these dying yellow leaves for compost for my worms. Pretty cool that I'm able to actually get some use out of these dead leaves. I'll add it to the compost later, but yes, I'm saving that for something. I'm gonna go to my bedroom and feed the fish in there and then also take care of some of the plants. These fish in here, there aren't very many, but I do have a lot of shrimp, so they like to eat it too. And we will come back to this soon because you'll be able to see all the shrimp trying to get the food on the top. The shrimp will eventually figure out that there's food here and then I'll come up there and try and get it. I need to water this, and then I probably need to water this plant, this Anthurium forgetii. I probably need to water my Philodendron domesticum. For most of the plants in my bedroom, I take them out to the balcony just because it's closer. Theo? No. As you can see, I don't have any more plants on this bottom level. because of Theo. Probably put some different type of decoration there instead of plants. I tried to bring as many out as I can because I can just water them all at once. Okay, so now that they're all out, I just shower them with water. And like I said before, I do like a general spritz and then I go in with the drench. This saves a lot of time when watering. So up here, really close to the Soltec grow light, I have my Drosera, also called Sundew. I use reverse osmosis water for these because they don't like minerals. So every once in a while, I'll just spray them like that. And it's pretty cool. There's live sphagnum moss on top. I just love the look of live moss. Oh, and then this Drosera Adelaide is beginning to flower. It's big stalk and then the flowers are really pretty. Yeah, it's also caught a ton of fungus gnats. Can you see the fungus gnats?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, all those little black dots on the leaves are all fungus gnats. I don't really mind fungus gnats anymore because it is food for my plants. It's like the apartment itself is just a giant terrarium. My mind is so powerful. I think this one's actually okay, but I'll give it a little top off. You see how sticky those little globules are? I don't even know what they'd be called. Can you see that on camera?
Doesn't come out too, oh, a little bit.
Here is my Dioscorea elephantipes that I had on that really cool branch, but I ended up removing it because the caudex of this plant was growing too large and it was pushing up against the branch. I didn't want the caudex to become deformed, so I took out the branch, sadly, because I think it looked extremely cool and very pretty. I didn't want to ruin the overall look of this plant, so I can just use that branch for something else. And then I do need to water this, but this is my first orchid that I ever got. It is a dancing lady orchid. I think it's an Onycidium. My mom bought this for me at a grocery store. I'm pretty excited to see these blooms. Hey, so cute, Slippin' Theo. I'm just gonna bring this outside to water. And then I can probably start bringing in some of my other plants I just watered. Oops, I accidentally turned on the hose. Excuse me, Theo. Just there. Sometimes I leave them on the mat to just dry a little bit more because this is actually a bath mat, so it's pretty absorbent. Oh, wait, now we can take a look and see if the shrimp are... Oh yeah, see? They have mostly all congregated around the food. Right now is probably my favorite time of the day when the sun is starting to shine through my window and the breeze comes in and it's just very pretty and very relaxing. I just thought I'd share that with you guys. I'm not sure if you guys remember, but this used to be my very tall variegated Adansonii. Something happened where I let it dry out too much and then a bunch of the older leaves yellowed and died off. So I decided to propagate it. It was already reaching the top of the pole, so I needed to do something. This is my dad's avocado plant that I need to water very frequently because it's in a tiny terracotta pot. And you can tell it's very sad looking. It definitely needs some water. Now I can bring my orchid in. I also forgot about this plant that we did a while ago. This happens a lot where I'll bring something out and then I'll see something else I need to do and then I'll do that and then I'll forget about what I was doing before. This orchid needs to dry a little bit more. Ooh. Now I blocked myself in. So I think I've done everything that I need to do today. I'm just gonna put this back and probably eat something. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's the first time I did something like this, so let me know if it is something you would like to see more of. It feels like I'm doing a plant tour, except I don't have to talk about everything so in depth. Thank you for watching, and goodbye. Mm-hmm.